Thank you. First, a quote about Telemann. A Lully fame was won, Corelli may be praised, but Telemann alone above all praise is raised. Telemann these days gets a very bad rap because in the 18th century, by the time J.S. Bach died, J.S. Bach was considered old, stuffy, and old-fashioned. And Telemann was very much in vogue. And history has kind of turned on poor Mr. Telemann. But the pieces I'm going to play for you today are six of his 12 newly discovered Fantasias for Viola da Gamba. Many people are very familiar with the unaccompanied works, sonatas and partitas of J.S. Bach, as well as the cello suites. One thing that you'll find very striking about these works is because they are labeled as Fantasias, they don't correspond to any particular regular form. It's not like I'm going to play a whole bunch of courants in a row for you. Every one of them is very different, incorporating all sorts of styles, such as Polish, Italian, French. Telemann loved to kind of synthesize all sorts of styles, and I hope that you will enjoy this first one in C minor. It is truly delicious.
Thank you.
When city councilor Plotz announced the appointment of J.S. Bach as cantor for the churches in Leipzig in 1723, his pronouncement stated, "Since the best man could not be obtained, mediocre ones would have to be accepted." While no one would refer to Bach in any way these days, his best man was no other than Telemann, who, connected to J.S. Bach, who had no competition because he was Carl Philipp Emanuel's godfather. But to give you an idea, Telemann started a collegium that Bach later directed that would become the Gewandhaus concerts, making that the longest continuous concert-giving organization in the world.
Thank you.
1830s, Telemann published what became known as his Paris Quartets, published in Hamburg. You're like, so what's the Paris connection? Well, about 8 years later, he traveled to Paris and got a special dispensation from the French crown to republish his music in France. And it was for a very unusual combination, for violin, flute, viola da gamba, and continuo. And so the first six of them that were originally published in Hamburg were much more Italianate in style, but then he published another six, which were called the new quartets, which, if you look at all of the tempo markings and such, are all in French. In the both sets of quartets, you had, Ojeter, who was a famous French flautist, was subscribed to it. J.S. Bach purchased it. Forqueray, who was a very famous gambist at the time. These works that I'm playing for you today come from a period when the viol was already on its way out in Europe. And in fact, after these were rediscovered, this is one of the last collections of unaccompanied viol music from the 18th century. And this next one's got a lot of really neat polyphonic stuff in it. Viola da Gamba music, as we often like, as you noticed with the choice of a couple of them so far, very curmudgeon-y ones, but I promise there's a number of lovely major ones like this next one. I say that, but the second movement is kind of heart-wrenching. Thank you. spanning a number of different periods, by the time Telemann dies in 1767, oh wait, 2017 is an anniversary year for that. Woohoo! Well, maybe we shouldn't be celebrating with such joy, but as 2017 nears, there's all sorts of celebrations going to be happening across the US and Europe. So always lots of joy, as you'll hear in this next one in D major.
Thank you.
into the depths of the Fantasia number 7, I want to thank everyone for being here and for getting to be a part of the series today. If you want to find out more about these Fantasias, and I'll be playing all 12 of them in the new year, you can follow us at newcomerbaroque.org, also on Twitter and Facebook at the same places. And I hope you like this last one. It's really gorgeous. For those of us who like our curmudgeon-y loud music.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.